Hey guys, Marshall90 here, and today we're going to be... today we're going to be replaying a game. This is a game that I played a long time ago called, Sluggish Morss, A Delicate Time in History. And as you know, for how much of a fan I probably am of Sluggish Morss, the reason I'm redoing this is because, like, the resolution was just shit on the last time. So we're gonna be redoing it right now. You should be looking at some gray lines. I haven't really booted up the game yet, but yeah, this time I have everything figured out. Or at least I should have things figured out. So this time there should be better mic quality, better resolution. I'm gonna turn the gain up a bit so you can hear me. And yeah, we're just gonna... we'll get right into it. This should be fun. So, let me just pull up the game. What I like about this game is it was made in the RPG Maker engine, so it's very simple. I guess what it's fun to kind of try and see, like, the grid lines that RPG Maker has, like, how snappy everything is. Somebody translate that binary. Not too late, but still. Someone in the comments translate that binary and tell me what it is. Plus, I'll probably try and point out some of the inside jokes or something. I'll probably talk to more people in this run.
When we talk for time. Now, as always is, history is at a delicate stage. Efforts are being made. All threads woven into patterns. The year is 14471. 860 HU, Histoire Urbaine. Within the coming century, changes have been predicted. Psychology and math combine with the billions of beings. Chance is now an exact science. Possibility shapes politics, control, and release.
It says anus pie at the end of it.
Control the lesser man, release, control the greater one.
Which is one of the jokes.
My name, Knig, the first of the super babies.
If you thought the thing at the beginning sounded a little familiar there, that was actually the exact same audio I used for, with this music in the background for one of my trailers for Spirit Walk. So yeah, there's a little fun fact.
Chance of ascendancy and only a 0.09 of an unfavorable outcome. That being said, There is one cloud in the clear sky, namely, you. The one thing beyond our predictions is your accuracy.
The reason I think this game is so important in the series is because this game offers more into like the lore or the overall story of Sluggish Morss, and as I'm going through this I can try to piece together as much as I can of the quote-unquote Sluggish Morss lore for you. That way I can kind of simplify these games and tell you what's going on. Either that, or you could just play Sluggish Morss ad infinitum on game. You can download all these games on Game Jolt. And yeah, you'd probably. Try and piece together your own theories.
The stars sure are out. Widow, I know the premonitions are nearing the present, but I feel there is real purpose.
God damn it, the music looped. Old friend, we always knew our work here would get us in trouble. We knew our actions well. La 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 la.
There's a saying of yours. Premonitions are true while they last. And do we not live in them?
Tenny, son. I don't know what that means. But I agree with that, with what that chick just said. A few minutes ago. Sort of. Eh. I like how a comma requires more of a pause than four periods or a single period. Some crazy text-to-speech going on there, huh? There's nothing over here or over here. That's just the way the parallax of the map is. I guess it's time to make a move.
Okay, Hotshot. Okay, I'm Puri.
Go tell it on the mountain, Pipkin.
Remember last time, Hotshot, you saw a face you will never forget.
We have a strict modus operandi with which to keep her borders. I have little to no time for your wanton advances. Are you okay back there, Woodock?
Just PG.
Markiplier played the original game of the Sluggish Morss franchise, or whatever. Which is weird, because if someone... Like, I mean, it was back when his channel was still pretty small, but still. I feel if this was on at a popular YouTuber's channel, it'd get a little more, just a little more popularity than what it has. Or at least Markiplier would find out about these other sort of, what do you call them, Sluggish Morss games. Where are we again? I wish I had a vapor eraser. It's what no one knows about you that allows you to know yourself. Like, 74% of what everyone says means something poetic or something. I don't know, because Jack King Spooner, whoever this guy is who made this game. I like his work, but literally almost 74% of NPC dialogue is just this, some poetic stuff. I'm glad we're here together. Are we even here at all? See? Look, this is madness. Mommy, what is the purpose of asking questions? I don't know, to know things? The greater the scientific advance, the more primitive the fear. Exactly. But describes today's society perfect beginning. The happy pleasure of the person alone, yes. What? I don't get that one. Hold on, let me turn this music down just a bit. At the end of all our exploring will be to arrive where we started and know the place for the first time. What? These people make no goddamn sense sometimes. War is the ultimate realization of modern technology. Pain is just another form of information. That's very true, because technically pain is just a strong electrical. The brain works in a way that it's literally just electricity. So like when you think of to move your finger, it's your brain telling you, sending an electric shock to your finger, a controlled electric shock that causes it to move, which is why you flinch up when you get electrocuted, like tasered or something, because that's causing your muscles to like contract. But yeah, so that when you get like cut or something, in reality what that is it's sending your arm or wherever you get cut is sending a signal to your brain, which is like, and then it sends something back with like an electric shock, like I was saying earlier, which lets you know that you're being hurt. And that's how pain is information. God dang, this room is annoying. You hear the super babies have someone new. Red button. Oh. This thing.
I am now aware.
Okay, good. Good for you. I stopped the noise. There's more to life than sitting there, interfacing. It might be a news flash to you. I feel like that's an insult telling me to get off the computer. I actually don't. I actually don't get on the computer that much at all, really. If anything, yeah, you've seen it. I haven't been able to get on like a computer or anything for a while now. And I've just started like re-uploading again with my music and everything. It was like almost, what was it, like 10 months maybe? Maybe a whole year that I was gone. And now I'm just starting to re-upload. And I'm here with all this music and being a complete tool. Ask yourself this question, do we have to be human forever? Consciousness is exhausted back now to ignorant manner. This is what we want. We want to be stones in a field. Yeah, sometimes people just want to blend in. Is this interesting, how weapons reflect the soul of the maker? If you look, at the top of this door. I don't think you can see it, but if you look close enough, there's actually a hidden face of a sewer baby. Like I said, I'm ashamed. Well, not ashamed, but I'm just, yeah, kind of ridiculous to know what a super baby is in this kind of situation. The funny thing is the background. This actually looks like a, what is it? It looks like a texture in like one of my photo editing softwares. I do not know. I don't really believe in God, so I think all prayers are just unanswered. It'd be like shouting in a dark room. But okay, I don't know. Yeah, hold on a minute. If I can... Well, if you look plain right here, you can already see there's the there's a video. Of what I was looking for, what I'm playing right now. Smoke from an extinguished emulated candle. What? Ember? An ember is a glowing hot coal. Four ways to put out a fire. WikiHow. WikiHow is like, I don't know. Imagine like you step into a room of like four idiots sitting in chairs and you ask them anything. And then what they explain to you is what WikiHow is. That's pretty much their guide. What put out the fire? Fires. Where does it go? Yeah, I think that's just it. When something like, I don't know, I guess when fire is, what do you call it? When fire is extinguished, or flames are extinguished, to be specific, fire requires three main ingredients, which is oxygen, a fuel source, and heat. Fire can actually maybe not heat, it's something else, but I can't remember. But yeah, fire obviously generates its own heat. Friction, maybe? I don't know, but yeah. When you have too much fuel, like too much gasoline, like if you were to pour, like, I don't know, 50 gallons of gasoline onto like a small match, it would put the match out because there's an overdose of fuel. Too much of one ingredient will put the fire out. When you blow on a fire too hard, like a candle, when you blow a candle out, what you're actually doing is fueling the fire so much that it overdoses, that it literally overdoses on air, oxygen, which causes it to just go out. So then, I don't know, I guess the heat from that fire slowly just disappears. Again, I don't know where they actually go, but yeah. Usually just say you die and then you go in the ground and everything's dark. It's depressing, but hey, you gotta make the most of life, am I right? Am I right? Okay. In a fountain at the mall? When you toss quarters in? What it does is it goes straight into fueling depression, crippling depression, because life is sad, kids. Yeah, sorry you had to learn it from me. Actually, why the hell are your kids on this channel? Dude, get off. What are your parents like, student? Nah. I'm just kidding. That's it? No more? I thought this was an interview. Repines director, you snow, 56, Supa baby. It says Supa instead of just super. I think that's another joke. Yeah, that's not the game, that's my dog.
I have been foretold that the population would get to the stage of systems. We understand the concept of now is dissipating. You know where it ends, don't you?
What he means about the population would get to the stage of systems. What that means is, there's actually an album cover out there of the soundtrack for this, and what that album cover says is that, I don't know, basically everybody got to the point where everybody became cyborgs, started loading their children up full of robot parts and stuff and corrupting them, which creates some of the very first super babies. And then other people start, like, overdosing on obsession when this thing called the id is released. I don't know, you can check Wikipedia or something about it, I don't know. And the concept of now is dissipating means basically that the universe is about to end soon, which is pretty much the whole timeline. The point in time, I guess, this takes place is near the end of the universe.
Of course, the end is our only interest. Now, but our past. Have you seen?
I like how the audio style switched up suddenly for no fucking reason. Time is our final hurdle. We'll start marking our sentience, document everything. If we leave a mark, then we might evade time itself, but time is more than our ruler. It is our kingdom. Very true. But you gotta think about it. There's this thing called, like, history class or something, and school in general, which kind of, you know, documents everything. So I don't know about that, but yeah, whatever floats your scrot.
Must. Might. Without time there would be no end.
Yeah.
Have you a gift that defies you, Widok? I hope not.
That quote-unquote gift that defies you, meaning, the main protagonist here, Widok, or Widok, I don't know. With this courier font, it's hard to tell if it's a V or a W sometimes. Sometimes it's both, I don't fucking know at this point. But, basically what this person is a quote-unquote premonitionist, which is somebody who can see the future. And then it is also somebody who can potentially change the future with their visions. Which is why sometimes that bad thoughts can cause, like, the end of the universe, per se. Wow, the music got crappy there for a second. Let's talk to these guys. Ongoing large scale is what makes history. Nostalgia on a personal scale leads to laws. Again, that makes no sense. Let's see what happens when I talk to you again. Have you not left yet? Your power worries me. No, that's just like a message to me in general. A lot of people would probably want me to leave. I have to bow into the carrier Morss. Another premonition? Soon I'll live more in my vision than I do in my conscious mind. She take my body, all I'm in need. This is a type of friend indeed. All she's got in it, well, the time. Daddy's on me. I like how you can't sprint in this area. God damn it, I hate this section. I love this ancient folk music. This came out like not even five years ago, man. Not that old, really. Well, this is the end of the universe, but then again, this music still sucks. Shh, it's starting. Huh, did you just shush me the bit? Well, you know what, you can...
And they didn't even put up a fight.
You can just...
They didn't even
shut up with your little... Did you just shush me, because...
But I never really had a doubt.
Who are you to say... Who are you to say that you can just say, nah, when you're, if you're liking music like this, I don't even like this music, and it was back during, like, a time where I actually liked modern music, which is sad, but if this chick's telling us off, telling us not, don't shush me, and you're listening to this, well, you're pretty much messed up in life, and I'm just rambling, aren't I? I don't even have a point to this. The Halo opera is just so bad. Is there seriously, like, fax noises in the back? Okay, let me scale this down before we lose half of the video. Me. You are disturbing me. We can always order a reflinch and experience it anew. I guess you're right, and we've not had a proper chance to talk since I got back from Huskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskuskusku
I'm looking now.
Jesus Christ, this music sucks. You really had us worried. We thought we'd lost you for sure. Physical maths is troublesome at the best of times, let alone you having to be the quadrant's soul bearer. You're telling me? I thought I was a goner. The premonitions in which I stored the maths were becoming out of control, like intense reverse deja vu. It's hard to explain. I like how that last period there didn't like take wasn't slow. Let's not think about what could have been. I wonder where this music game from. Jack King. I found a typo. Huge fan of rework, but I found a typo. Oh, finally that fucking. Are you serious? The fucking music looped. This music came from like 2012. And surprisingly, it's not about the video game. I know this is crazy and romantic of me, but I like to imagine that wherever that music has been passed down from. Passed down from is where we come from. Huh, I think that too. I wonder if we'll ever know from which system we came. My bet is it's the Upsilon Andromedae, the best secret of the stars' beginnings. They are probably looking up at us as we speak, just staring at the sky. What wonders it holds.
Saving grace. written all over your face. Baby.
And the fucking fax machine sounds kick up again. I like how these are the only two girls in the drama who speak French. Cause you know, no one else near the end of the universe speaks French. Speak to me, dammit. Nice picture of Skrillex there. He really caught her good side, didn't you? The kind that makes it look like she didn't shave half the head off her hair. What?
Welcome to Sluggish Morss, Miss Y Doc. I bid you a comfortable trip on board our intertemporal passenger carrier. My name is Milvia. I shall be your mainframe.
Well, hi Milvia. Glad to be here. This music in the background is called Disco Dies Tonight. It is the funkiest music. It is really good. If you download the game, you could probably listen to it in the files of the game. I'll leave a link in the description of this game. Wait, when was this? No, I can cast it.
Daydat, Vicente and Foro, home to the Yelkin, radius, unknown, surface area, unknown, orbits, Almansuta, the outstretched, paw, moon, Almankip 6, the shoulder, of the Pleiades, note, documentation futile, ether heights have been detected. Gani Daydat. Said no care. Heart of the known universe, home to the Manag, radius.
You fool, that says heart of the galaxy.
45 kilometers, surface area, 398,600,000 square kilometers, orbits, Albas, the weight, moon, Dinipal Asat to the lion's tail, note, population 46 billion, crisis level, said no care. Just note. Generator planet, radius, 4,371 kilometers, surface area, 329,100,000 square kilometers, orbits, Al-Hadi, the hatching place, moon, fixed toa, just no.
I think that's a pure joke right there, that one of these main planets is named Just Know.
Cuspus Falcon, home to the Mars, radius, 6,371 kilometers, surface area, 650,100,000 square kilometers, orbits, Miss, the Dream Maker, Moon, XI far far 6 Tus, Cuspus Falcon.
Okay, that's it, I guess, for the, And the music loops.
Why, Doc? I wonder if you could help. Two of the.
Okay, now's the part of the thing where I gotta run around looking for a bunch of robots acting like a bunch of gay little fish. What are you saying? Okay, I got one. Time. And to the next one. 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 Wait, what? What are you saying? Yeah, I still can't. What? Slow down, I can't. Shut up! There, killed it. Are you proud of me, Miss Android Lady? Yeah, let's go. Hey, look. If you look over here, it's a reference to the first game. Okay, let's go.
Captain, something is wrong. The bound has dislodged certain qualities of psyche, long since lost down the evolutionary path.
Impossible. There is nothing dormant.
And this is the part where the id comes into play.
I'm afraid he's right, Captain. Thor has been admitted to the quarantine yard already.
We have a quarantine yard.
That was supposed to be a question, but it came out like a sentence. Again, great text-to-speech program you got over here.
Yes, no, I think it was partly facetious, but was built in case such a thing might happen.
Somebody in the comments, look up facetious and then put the definition in the comments.
How historical, and what are the what's the word symptoms?
What are the what's the word symptoms? Cool. Okay, that's not an appropriate voice for a little girl. Don't know what these mean.
As you can see, Captain, this is a 1209. If this is a latent space expression, then we...
She just got real jazzy bell. There's been an outbreak in subdivision 847.
847?
It's like an incredulous case of violence, souls every place.
Every place? Also, 847 subdivisions. I wonder how many there are, really. But, I mean, that's a lot of subdivisions. But, I mean, it, like, depends, really. If that's just a triple-digit address. Or, yeah, whatever. Also, yeah. Basically, what that means is the, quote-unquote, id is now on the loose, I guess.
Why on my watch? There hasn't been a case of violence for 9 millennia now. Why on my watch?
9 millennia? How much is a millennia? Somebody look that up, too, in the comments. My, wait, I can't move. Cryo is now available to the rear of the ship. Access the code. So, my friend Phoenix, he watches this, as well as a few other nameless people. Phoenix, I know you're watching and listening. Wait, no, go back. Look up what... Yeah, look up anything I tell you and then put it in the comments. Please? Okay, I'll get back to you. Oh, this is a headache right here. Hear that?
The code might be 7492. The code might be 7492.
Okay, we got the code. Let's go. Even though I already knew it, in fact, I have it memorized just because of this little event right here. The person who made this game clearly had a lot of what is it? Obviously had a lot of experience in programming, because some of the stuff in this game requires more than just RPG Maker skills. Like the title menu, for example. Ooh, pretty. And it's the music from earlier. Cool. We're almost near the end of the game, actually. This bridge actually reminds me of, like, Halo. The game, I mean. What is this? A strip club? Looks like it. Or wait, no, this isn't a club. This isn't indoors, this is actually like a town square or something. What the fuck are you? Some sort of gangly, scarce looking Sasquatch? Time may change me, but I can change time. That is with this sluggish Morss experience. I see. Question mark. Ah, cool. You don't want to see this guy, not when you can treat oneself down here. Well then, Miss Ugly Cunt, you can just go fuck yourself, because have you even looked in the mirror? I mean, you have no eyes, plus I'm not sure that face is doing you any miracles. Get out of my way. Okay, so we're on Huskis Feltkin. Here's when things get trippy, because then you start seeing naked kids running around for some reason. Now there's three. I like how this guy intentionally blocks your way like a dick. And then there's these losers. They're addicted to this infernal sound, a normative kind of music, as the past tribes call it. Mm-hmm. Don't do drugs, kids. Literally, don't do drugs. The name is in the file names. It's literally called drug music. Wudok, you have no idea, do you? Correction, you have no idea. I, well then, who am I? Jag, the outcast super baby. Very good. You seem to be garnering knowledge through and during your fortune telling. This is most impressive. Of course, that is exactly why you can see me. Let me ask you one thing. Where do you think we are now? Well, I'm here now. We will be, and when that time comes, you will know what there isn't to tell me, and I will know what to do, for nothing is ever determined. I will tell you one thing, Wudok. Have you seen the sky here? If you could look at the sky, then things will become more clear, the way it is now clear. I gotta get out of here. meeting of some sort with a bunch of Asian babies.
You know, there has been a faith expression caused by the intertemporal craft, Sluggish Morss.
Then why'd you ask why we were here?
This expression has caused a dormant quality of the human psyche to appear. The id.
You see? He explained everything.
This? We can do no thing. The cause? Widok, the projectionist. We can do something. Our intent is to guide her away from bad thoughts.
Yeah, see, the plan here is, supposedly projectionists are able to, affect the future based on these quote-unquote premonitions that they have. So basically the end of the universe, which is happening soon, can be avoided. But because of later events in the storyline, it's going to be definitely come, because she will now know about it, which will cause her to know. I like how there's a sloth. Like, I don't know if you can see this, but if you look, I'm like over the, I don't know, I guess, over one of the shoulders of this baby that's yakking their mouth right now, there's a sloth licking the window, the behind of the window. I guess would be another joke. If anyone out there speaks, Chinese, please translate. And yes, I know that's Chinese. Or wait, maybe it's Japanese. It might be Japanese, because I think that there's a Japanese symbol in the first sentence, the second part of the first sentence right there.
Correct. Sunlight used her for water. Sunlight used her for commerce. We must keep her view clear without distraction.
Exactly.
Her view is the golden egg. And what is the thing that is of importance? Surely, we can guess that it concerns our fate.
I like how there was pauses between the parts where it indented, or, you know, where they hit the return key, I guess. Also, the baby in the top middle, you see? With the one with the most color, I guess. She did not sound like that in the first game.
And what of our fate? All we can say is that we are fated.
I feel like you said that before.
My understanding is that she is predicting what we are saying as we speak. My second guess is that she has no idea what the conclusion is, but that she is nearing it.
I like the sound of like hanging up the phone near the end.
你好,我是慧,谢谢你测试我的声音,请输入要命的文字。
Okay, now I know that I probably just spitting out Chinese bullshit, because that first word is hello in Chinese. Even though this is probably Japanese text. You racist bastards, get your culture right, Jack. Love your game, by the way. Okay, now that That ugly cunt is gone. This is us seeing this guy, apparently. What? What's happening? You've seen things, Woodock. These things are more than predictions. Now they are obligations. We tried to harry and shatter your vision so that you might be able to live. Our efforts were stilted. This thing, I don't know. He's not the devil, but he is a devil, I guess, because he's pretending that he's, like, one of them, trying to steer her vision away so that this doesn't end up happening, but he shows this to her anyways, even though she's never figured it out or seen it before. You need to see what you carry. You need to give yourself purpose. The reason you were selected is for one foresight. And this is the universe ending, supposedly. The watermelon planet just blew up. Laughable, you stupid creatures dragging your guts across time. The galaxies will collide. They have done already. Some will die. Not only are you mortal on an individual level, you are mortal as pure existence. The rarity of objective's reality, and to think it is mortal. Laughable. And that's the end, by Jack King Spooner. See you right there. In order of appearance, as the good friend, I would not say that's a good friend. Liz Lawrence as Vidoc Daydot. John Clive as himself. Chloe Smith as Pangel Tease. Monica Silas was as Milvia. Paul Hach as Green Fingers. Andy Phillips, more like Phil Collins if you ask me, as Scottish L12. Ellen Wood is Sluggish Morss. Laura Lewis as Standpoint. Garcia Ray as the girl with way too deep a voice to be a girl. And his Grab. Emily. I don't know what that accent mark is. What is that accent mark? How is it pronounced? Somebody in the comments, tell me. Gasp. Emily Overton as Gulp. Saddam as Id Victim. Those dreadlocks, man. Emma Lewis Bass as Ugly Cunt. Sound design art blah 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 by Jack King Spooner. I'm gonna take my headphones out. This part's just disturbing. Like, you guys can listen. I'm gonna do something else for now. If you can't tell, this is the audio from Boonful World, which is a song I have made. That song though is actually shortened. I'm gonna play the full version of this, but it's fucking disturbing. Which is why I'm gonna do something else. I can't even listen to this, I've heard it before, it's shocking. I'm gonna do something else.
Bye. my throat. I will bite your dick off. If you don't fucking fuck me now, harder. Fuck me. Fuck my throat. I will bite your dick off. If you don't fucking fuck me now, fucking fuck my guts out, speak on it. I want to feel you stabbing deep inside me. Deeper. Harder. Fuck me. Fuck my throat. Harder. Fuck me. Fuck my throat. Harder. Fuck me. Harder. Fuck me. Harder.
Okay, we're ending it there. That's, like I said, that's disturbing, and in fact, I think that's gonna get, yeah. Good job, Jack. You managed to disturb me. Fucking me. And if I can quickly show you people kindly. Just give me a moment here. Let me just... any day now. And then, wait, are you kidding me? Where's the rest of my stuff? It loaded. Never mind. You've managed to disturb me. And I drew this. Like, what even is this? We already talked about this. Alright, back to whatever. Okay, guys. I'm also 90 subscribed to become a duck. This was my replay of Sluggish Morss. A dark time in history. Or a delicate time in history, I'm sorry. But yeah. Bye.